Chase Queen Challenge Puzzle. So this is the topic in this session. So at first we are going to discuss the problem statement. A challenge is to set n queens on an n cross n grid so that no queen can take any other queen. That means this is my n cross n grid. Here this value of n is equal to 4. So we are having 4 rows and 4 columns. Here we are supposed to place 4 queens, that means n number of queens, in such a way that no two queens will be in the same row, in the same column and in the same diagonal. So just consider this queen. So she is here. So there is no queen in the same row, same column and in the same diagonal. And this is true for rest 3 queens. So that is the famous n queens problem. Queens can move horizontally, vertically or along a 45% diagonal. The following diagram shows a solution for n is equal to 4 number of queens. A solution to this puzzle can be represented by a special permutation of the list of 1, 2, 3, 4. So queen number 1, queen number 2, in this way we are having up to queen number 4. For example, the solution pictured above can be represented as 3142. This particular solution can be represented as 3142 in a form of a list. What is 3 here? It denotes that the first queen will be at the third column. We know that ith queen will be at the ith row. So that is quite obvious. First queen will be at the first row, second queen will be at the second row, fourth queen will be at the fourth row. So that is not a problem to be discussed. Here we are maintaining or we are expressing the column number. Here 3 means the first queen will be at the third column, 1 means the second queen will be at the first column, and 4 means the third queen, because it is the third number here and the value is 4, so that it indicates third queen will be at the fourth column and the last queen or the fourth queen will be at the second column. So this is the solution. If I get, then I can understand that where which queen has been placed. So now we are going for a prolog procedure to be developed, an in-out prolog program to implement this problem. We shall have to write a procedure called say solve, which will take only one argument. For sample, goals are as follows. So here is the goals for us. So if you go for solve P, then P can have this sort of values. Here we have considered n is equal to 8. So this particular problem can have multiple different solutions and all those solutions will get listed. But using the setup function, if we accumulate all the solutions and if we are putting that one in set, and later if you calculate the length of this set to L, we can find that L is equal to 92. After giving all the solutions, L is equal to 92 means we are having 92 different possible solutions for n is equal to 8. So for 8 queens problem. So let us go for one practical demonstration where we will be writing this code in prolog, and we shall execute that one and the required outputs will be obtained. So for the better clarity regarding this puzzle solved, so here is a demonstration for you. In this n queens challenge puzzle, we know that all the queens are to be placed in distinct rows, columns and diagonals. So whenever nth queen, if you consider the nth queen, then obviously it will be placed at the nth row. Ith queen will be placed at the ith row. So row wise there will be no coincidence that two queens will be found in the same row. And in the given output, when the query will be executed in the output, if I find that all the column numbers are distinct, so that will also ensure that no two queens have placed in the same column. So row wise any kind of conflict or column wise any kind of conflict can easily be detected and can be avoided. But depending upon the diagonal wise whether two queens will be placed in the same diagonal, so for that we should consider this one. So two queens are on the same diagonal if and only if the sum of the row and column is the same for each. They are on the same diagonal. Here the diagonal will be like this. Here the diagonal will be like this. If and only if the difference of their rows and columns is the same number.
So that's why for diagonal wise any kind of conflict, I have written this respective code. So this code is for whether to check whether this x1 plus y1 for this diagonal and this x1 minus y1 for this diagonal. So diagonal wise check has been completed here. So now this is the PALM is the respective predicate which is taking this list as input and producing z as output. So it is producing all possible combinations of this list in z. So permutation y will be found in w and then delete member xz will be the w, because here you see this is xy is the total list and its permutation is z. That means this z is also containing x. So if the permutation of y is w, then obviously if we delete x from z, then w will be obtained. So now this is our delete member. So that means if that item has been found at the head, then I shall be remaining with the tail part for the delete operation. And if the item has been found in the tail part, then the head will remain intact. This will be s, because delete member xr will produce s as output. So in this way, where our main predicate to be executed here is solve, and it will solve this problem in this way. Let me discuss also this all difference. So that means here all different will take place in this particular list. If x is not a member of y, if x is not a member of y and all different y, in that case obviously you can find that all the members in this list are different. So I think it is better, let us go for the execution of this code for the understanding. So let me execute the query like this. So solve p. So if you execute solve p, then we are getting one solution of this n queens problem. Here the value of n is equal to 8. So how these 8 queens can be placed in 8 different columns, in 8 different rows, and there will be no conflict along the diagonals also. So that has been tested for this output. So now if we go for the other solutions, then I shall have to press A here, then I shall get all the possible solutions for this n queens problem when the value of n is equal to 8. But if I am to get that how many number of solutions we have got, so we are going to use our inbuilt predicate set of, which will make a set. This particular set will be containing all possible solutions that has been produced, and for that purpose we have used the inbuilt predicate set of here. So now let me execute the same. So here we are getting that we are getting in total 92 such solutions for this given problem, and here are the respective answers which has been kept in the set. So in this way we have demonstrated how this n queens challenge puzzle can be implemented in Prolog. Thanks for watching this video.